last year, flag-draped coffins have returned from Afghanistan. Now we know Vladimir Putin pays a bounty for the murder of American soldiers. Donald Trump knows too and does nothing. Putin pays the Taliban cash to slaughter our men and women in uniform. And Trump is silent, weak, controlled. Instead of condemnation, he insists Russia be treated as our equal. Instead of retaliation, he invites Putin to America. When Trump tells you he stands by the troops, he's right. Just not our troops.
这是共和党内反川普组织林肯计划最新的宣传片。川普上台后，一路与通俄门与阿富汗战事纠缠，如今这两件麻烦事叠加，又向川普袭来。
The U.S. has gathered intelligence that Russian intelligence officers have offered to pay bounties to Taliban fighters who kill Americans.
The New York Times, which broke the story late Friday, also reported that, quote, the intelligence finding was briefed to President Trump.
The Washington Post reports that the Russian bounties are believed to have resulted in the deaths of several U.S. service members.
据《纽约时报》和《华盛顿邮报》的报道，美军此前在塔利班一个据点发现大量美钞。盘问被捕的武装分子后发现，这是俄罗斯提供的赏金，鼓励塔利班武装分子猎杀包括美军在内的驻阿富汗联军。调查也表明，最近三年来多起美军伤亡事件都与俄罗斯的悬赏有关。《华邮》的报道更指出，驻阿富汗美军将有关情报呈交上级后，白宫曾召开高层会议讨论应对俄罗斯的措施。
却遭到了冷处理。A briefing is created for then National Security Advisor John Bolton. The meeting was described as not an urgent meeting. Again, it's not. Russian meddling in Afghanistan is not a new thing, so it wasn't seen as an urgent meeting. And there was also no actionable intelligence in there. But it is a meeting that they held.
美国多家媒体对这新闻进行了后续追踪报道，一时直起千层浪，置美国自家子弟兵安危于不顾，更无视于任何有关俄罗斯的指控。川普确实犯了大忌，但他第一时间发了推文，否认自己或白宫任何高层有听取过类似的情报，也一如既往的痛斥纽时就是个假新闻大户。
The CIA director, NSA, National Security Advisor, and the Chief of Staff can all confirm that neither the President nor the Vice President were briefed on the alleged Russian bounty intelligence.
But has he been since briefed, since all of these reports came out?
So let me back up and say this, that there is no consensus within the intelligence community on these allegations.
白宫发言人为组织辩护，不否认情报的存在，但强调没有确切证据的情报没必要让总统川普知道。只是这说法并没有打消外界的疑虑，反而激起国会对川普处理类似情报能力的质疑。President
Trump, you lose either way. If you weren't briefed on this important report, how can you run an administration where something this important is not brought to your level? And if you were told about the report and did nothing, that's even worse. Shame on you.
而川普连任的竞选对手拜登也适时的补上一刀.
His entire presidency has been a gift to Putin, but this is beyond the pale. It's a betrayal of the most sacred duty we bear as a nation to protect and equip our troops when we send them in the harm's way. And it's betrayed. It's a betrayal of every single American family. With a loved one serving in Afghanistan or anywhere overseas.
On the issue of Russia and bounties.
面对外界的质疑，川普终于亲上火线。
And I'm sure I don't see many things that they don't think rose to the occasion. This didn't rise to the occasion. And from what I hear, and I hear it pretty good, the intelligence people didn't even, many of them didn't believe it happened at all. I think it's a hoax. I think it's a hoax by the newspapers and the Democrats.
川普回击说，这是民主党阵营卑劣的竞选手段，把责任撇得一干二净。На
эту тему уже однозначно высказались не только в Российской Федерации, но и в самих Соединенных Штатах Америки, в частности президент США, глава Пентагона. Он заявил об отсутствии доказательств, подтверждающих такие, как они сказали, фальшивые измышления.
而俄罗斯也用了白宫的说法，否认悬赏杀美军的情报。 只是情报界对俄罗斯的涉案一点也不意外。对莫斯科来说，保持塔利班的攻势绝对是让美国持续陷入阿富汗战事泥淖的最佳途径。而美国人也曾在阿富汗对前苏联干过同样的事。
I think we need to take a little bit of a historical back view and understand that we essentially did the same thing to the Russians when they were occupying Afghanistan in the 1980s. Look, we provided the Mujahideen with weapons, with Stinger missiles. I can understand, given the history, why they would be doing this.
1978年，激进的阿富汗人民民主党在苏联支持下政变成功，在阿富汗推动无神论的共产主义，这让许多穆斯林开始加入圣战，阿富汗陷入动荡，让苏联在1979年挥军南下。而此时的美国认为有机可乘。
Yeah, and that will deal first with Iran, then with Afghanistan and the regional implications.
时任美国国家安全顾问的布里辛斯基建议总统卡特支持阿富汗的圣战，透过巴基斯坦援助军火。布里辛斯基更亲自到前线对圣战士喊话助威。
No, that land over there is yours. You'll go back to it one day because your fight will prevail and you'll have your homes and your mosques back again because your cause is right and God is on your side.
The purpose of coordinating with the Pakistanis would be to make the Soviets bleed for as much and as long as is possible.
除了武器和资金，美国 CIA 也秘密训练圣战士的武装行动，其中包括来自沙烏地阿拉伯的奥萨马·宾拉登。与苏联的对抗让他声名大噪，当时的美国《时代》杂志更以圣战勇士来赞誉他。而如同美国之于越战，苏联也陷入阿富汗战事泥沼，有 1.5 万人丧命异乡，在1988年黯然退兵。
On my orders.The United States military has begun strikes.
Since America's war in Afghanistan began in October 2001, more than 2,250 American uniformed men and women have been killed in that mission.
而跟随前苏联的步伐，911事件后，美国针对阿富汗塔利班发动了这场报复性战争，已成为美国史上最长、打了19年的海外战事。
Look at Afghanistan, what a mess.
历经三任总统，川普接下了这烂摊子。早在上台之前就多次公开喊话，从阿富汗撤军成了他的竞选承诺。华府也一反过去不和恐怖分子谈判的立场，派出特使从2018年起私下与塔利班阵营接触，经过一连串渐进式协商，终于在今年2月达成协议，直到明年美军将全面撤出阿富汗。一些分析也认为，在与塔利班谈判的关键时刻，急于从阿富汗撤军的川普获知俄罗斯悬赏杀美军的情报，不论真假，确实是个棘手的问题。但不管基于什么样的原因，无法保护美国前线部队更隐匿俄罗斯的行径，这对任何美国人来说都无法接受。
Well, the first thing I see is an apparent betrayal by the President of the United States or our armed forces.
背叛让川普的自家共和党支持者也看不下去了，即便白宫方面紧急向国会情报委员会做了简报，白宫国家安全顾问欧布莱恩也亡羊补牢似的向俄罗斯提出警告，但美国跨党派的国会议员已要求对此事展开彻底调查。川普这回对情报的知情不报，不只是通俄门疑云的延续，更加上背叛罪名的枷锁，而声讨舆论持续延烧，他的总统连任之路恐怕更加渺茫。